All right, guys, so Jen has told me that in many of our recent videos, people have had questions about what?
Appliances that we use.
Inside the cabin. So we're going to show up to you real quick today, give you a rough idea of how much electricity they use. So there's lots of ways to use appliances in an off-grid situation or using solar. We chose a more direct and simple route. Mm-hmm. We have everything in the cabin here running on 120 volt, just like a normal house. Other cabins, other houses, other people who use solar, you can use DC appliances. But those appliances cost more money. They're less readily available. They're triple the cost.
Yeah, of, it's not good.
Yeah, a regular DC or propane refrigerator will run you thousands of dollars, $2,000 to $3,000 actually. So we have an apartment size, I would say, refrigerator. It's about 10 cubic feet, so it's a medium size. It's not a small dorm size, 6 or 7 cubic feet, and it's not a full size 18 or 20 some cubic feet refrigerator. This is a $300 refrigerator. We could buy 10 of these refrigerators if we had to, for the price of one propane special refrigerator. And one of the common misconceptions with refrigerators is that they draw a lot of power. Well, a lot of refrigerators are Energy Star rated now. They don't run 24/7. And this refrigerator literally draws like 170 watts when the compressor kicks on and runs for a little bit. And then when it's just barely running from time to time throughout the hours of the day, it hits only like 60, 70 watts. And that's not continuous. That's just a few times an hour just to keep it cool. So very efficient and not a huge energy draw like people believe. People misunderstand that. Refrigerators aren't that hard to run off-grid or with solar. So what's another disadvantage other than the upfront cost of running a refrigerator on propane?
You could run out of the propane.
Yeah, it's going to cost you a couple dollars, $1 to $2 a day and of propane, and you have to replenish the fuel supply.
Where when we go away for a few days to go downstate to see family or anything, we can leave everything in the fridge running because we know it's not making a huge draw on our solar. So it's a huge relief and time and space saver.
Yep. And no needed fuels. No added changing out propane tanks. No added cost. Our system's set up. Our solar set up and we're running. No worries.
$300 fridge and we're good.
All right. So what's your next favorite appliance?
That would be our coffee maker because you can't start a day without coffee.
Yep. And we don't need a fancy coffee maker, right?
Nope. This is not like any, it's not like $500 machine or anything.
Is it like 40 bucks?
Yeah, this one was 40. We used to have a glass standard one you'd get at any of those stores, 20 bucks. But a viewer a couple years ago told us to get the stainless steel one because it keeps coffee hot for hours and hours, guys. It's great. Because if I wake up before Jay and I want to have some coffee and he wakes up a couple hours later, the coffee's still hot for him, so we don't have to rerun at the coffee maker, which is a huge energy saver because we were doing that before and it was drawing lots of energy. So this is probably one of the best investments we've made appliance-wise.
Yeah, so this coffee maker draws about 700 watts to perk the coffee for about 10 minutes every morning. And then it turns off.
Yep. And more energy.
Yep, and the coffee stays hot for 2 or 3 hours. We don't have to have a little tray underneath that kicks on every 5 to 10 minutes. And uses extra energy to keep it warm.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something you guys should check out. Jen's going to put a link in the description box below for you guys so you can find it easy.
It's a Black & Decker. Seriously, it was like $40 to $45 at Walmart.
So when you're running off solar or you're off grid, a lot of people will try to perk coffee, use a percolator, heat it with propane. We use electricity.
So, we're super happy with this coffee maker.
And thank you to the viewer who told us about that.
I don't remember who it was. It was a couple of years ago. So
we appreciate the suggestion and we wanted to share that with you guys. So if you're interested in a coffee maker like this, this would work great for camping as well. Say you're running your camper off a gas generator or solar for your camper. This is perfect solution. Hmm. So do we have a microwave here at the cabin?
Nope, no microwave.
But what do we do if we want to like heat up leftovers, or say we want to cook something real simple and not get all, you know, microwave gross?
This is an air fryer, and we got this last fall, actually. So we've had it for almost a year. Super easy to reheat our food. It only uses 1100 watts when it's heating up and cooking food. And we only need to use it once or twice a week. Nice, easy, efficient way to warm up our food. I don't like cold leftovers. Jay will eat it cold, but I like to rewarm my food up so I can easily warm it up. A better alternative than a microwave, and it doesn't take up space in the kitchen like a microwave does, which is also, when you're living in a tiny home like we are, very important, because this is small and we can just put it in the cupboards when we're not using it.
And how much did that cost you?
I think this cost like $20.
$20 to $30. It
was like $20 to $30 at Walmart. It's just the Walmart brand of it, but it's small, it's not a big size, but it does what we need for two people.
So what do we cook most of our food on, though?
We cook almost all our food on the propane stove here. Doesn't use any electricity at all, so this is our best appliance here.
Most energy efficient one of all, yep, right?
Most energy efficient, and we've got a big 100 gallon, right?
So our propane stove is a vintage propane stove. Some of the newer stoves that you can run with solar or off-grid, even if they are propane, have like a heating coil inside of them, and they can draw up to 400 or 500 watts when you're using the oven. Now, most propane or stovetops do not require any electricity use, because you just have your simple burners, okay? We have this hooked up to a 100-pound propane tank outside. It's run through the floor out to that with a flexible hose, and we haven't replaced that 100-pound propane tank in...
This would be 3 years we've had the stove in here now, yeah. So 3 years.
Propane stoves and stovetops do not use a ton of energy or a ton of gas. A newer style stove that works off of DC or propane, some of them have an electric igniter that you can use D style batteries. You can use 2D batteries to ignite the oven. Those are a good investment. You're going to spend $2,000 to $3,000 on a propane stove, though, that is designed to work with a solar system or an off-grid application. That's a good energy saver there, but they are quite expensive. They're $2,000 to $3,000 for a stove. So do you like your vintage propane stove?
I love my vintage stove. I love everything about it, so.
So look for one, guys. Make sure that they are in good condition when you buy one. Otherwise, you'll have trouble, you know, fixing it and finding parts, but this has treated us really good for the last 3 or 4 years.
Mm-hmm. So. Something you might notice that we don't have here in the kitchen, because we just talked about kitchen appliances, was we don't have a dishwasher. Yep. But it's just the two of us, so there's no need for a dishwasher when it's only two people. We don't need a dishwasher.
I've never owned a dishwasher, never had one, never grew up with one, and we had a family of six. So we just wash dishes by hand, mm-hmm. Primarily my mom, but...
But it's easy, but it's not that big a deal. We just wash our dishes after we're done eating, it's pretty easy.
So what else do we use electricity for here in the cabin? So you guys have seen all the appliances we use here in the kitchen. A few other things, obviously we use lights. Cabins have lots of lights, all run on solar. We have ceiling fans that we frequently use to push air around, and lights. One of the newer appliances that we have come to use and love is our Minisplit.
Mm-hmm. It's been a very welcome addition. We've had it for probably about 3 months now.
And we have used it a lot. We've had a lot of really warm days and in the, you know, close to 90 degrees, and we could turn it on and put air conditioned air right into our little 500 square foot cabin.
Yep.
And it keeps it right at 70 degrees, no problem, right?
Yep.
And then more recently, we've actually been in the 40s at night, and we wake up and the cabin is in the high 50s. Do you like it in the hot in the high 50s?
No.
Does anybody really want a cabin to be in the high 50s?
Mm.
Not really. I'm okay with it being cooler, but I get chilly now too, so... So
Mr. Cool has been a very awesome appliance that we've added here, and it's very energy efficient, right? You were very surprised with it.
I was surprised. I never thought I could run an air conditioning / heating unit like a mini split to heat our cabin. It's alleviated a ton of problems. This is a single wall unit. You can get different sizes of this unit. You can get different zones where you have multiple wall units. We just need one because we have one big space here and it cools it off and heats it very well.
Yes.
This has eliminated us having to start a fire when it's in the 50s in the cabin. It's not really practical to start a fire when the cabin's in the 50s.
Right.
And it's going to be 80 degrees like it's been 75 today, but it gets cool at night.
Mm-hmm.
So we just kick this on for a couple hours in the morning. The heat mode seems to draw right around 400 to 500 watts and heats this place up in like 45 minutes. Nice, mild temperature, right?
Yep.
So, and the air conditioning, from what we've noticed, runs between 700 watts and 900 watts. More often than not, it's running around 700 watts to run air conditioning. So I guess the Mr. Cool Mini Split, it comes with a dual level pump outside. There's an outside unit at the edge of the deck. We have a whole video on this if you guys want to check it out, the install of this unit, but it's very affordable, very energy efficient, and solves a lot of problems for us.
Yes.
So I highly recommend you check that out.
Yes.
Now you might say solar, 700 watts, 800, 900 watts to run air conditioning is a lot of power. Well, typically here when the temperatures are that warm in the 90s or high 80s, we have nice sunny days. We have a 1,000-watt solar array out there, and then we have a dual-axis tracking system that's 1,200 watts of solar as well. On a sunny day, that will run and keep our air conditioning and keep the heat going. A couple thousand watts of solar panels and a medium-sized solar system can very easily keep up with refrigeration, coffee making, cooking, lights, fans, air conditioning now, and a little bit of heat.
Mm-hmm.
We have our computers plugged in all day long. I make videos. Jen tutors and helps with all of the YouTube channel stuff here. So she's on her computer a large portion of the day as well. And we have no...
Run it just kind of like a regular household, guys.
Yeah. You can complicate it and run things on DC power. You can get DC lights, 12-volt lights. You can get all kinds of appliances that run on DC, but all that stuff is quite expensive compared to normal appliances. And not only does it cost more, but they're not readily available. Like if this refrigerator died, we could run up to the big box store and replace it in a couple hours. You're not doing that with a special DC appliance.
Yep. That's true.
So what's one other thing that we have to have here at the cabin that doesn't require solar but is pretty important to our existence?
You need a wood stove. It's kind of a really important appliance. And like Jason said, it's not solar run.
HVAC systems, furnaces, regardless of their style, and full-size air conditioners are very hard on electric use. And even a furnace, like a forced air furnace, has a big motor or a good-sized motor that runs a lot to push air around. That's going to draw a lot on your solar. So if you could heat with wood, I would highly recommend that.
Love our wood stove.
Yeah. Jen's a huge fan of our wood stove. That's probably her. She probably likes it more than me. More than me. Like, I like it, but she likes that wood. She had to get rid of the wood stove or get rid of me.
Yep.
I wouldn't stand a chance.
And the dogs. The dogs agree too.
Yeah. They can live without me, but they cannot live without the wood stove. So that's one area I guess we kind of cheat a little bit, is heating with wood. But like I said, now we have the mini split to make up for shortcomings when you can't burn a fire.
Mm-hmm.
And we have it pretty good here at the cabin.
Yep.
Yes. If you guys have any questions...
Yep, about any of the appliances or anything or any questions
or tips for anybody that might be watching this video, please put them in the comments section below.
Mm-hmm.
That's the whole point of us making these little videos here and there throughout this journey, is to help others.
Yeah, because we had to learn by trial and error. So if we can help someone else avoid that.
Yep, and there's other channels out there that show you how to do things differently, and that's fine. Sometimes they complicate things. We don't like complicated here.
Nope.
And
simple.
This, you know, simple works, and it works for us, and we like it that way, yes?
Yep. So. Our solar runs good on all these appliances almost all year. Sometimes in the winter we get a little questionable, but...
Occasionally, we have to run a gas generator in the winter to make up for our shortcomings when we have no sun. But
that's once a year, maybe.
Yeah, I think we ran the generator like 3 or 4 times last winter. You know, like I said, we just minimize things, but not in an uncomfortable way.
Right.
So thanks, guys, for hanging out with us during this video. We hope it helped somebody. Please like and share this video with somebody who might be interested in it. It helps our channel a lot.
Yep.
And we appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you so much, and it's the best way to support the channel.
Yep. Best wishes, everybody.